open to the elements of art, page one.
The elements of art, the building blocks of art. These are the things that you put together to make a work of art. They're hardly ever used alone, so you need to think about how these things all come together. They're the building blocks of art. Line, it could be organic or geometric. Actual line, implied line, three-dimensional line. Shape, organic shape, geometric shape, has height and width. Form, it could be organic form or geometric form, has height, width, and depth. Value, high key value is light, low key value is dark. Texture, actual texture or implied texture. Color, we've got three main categories, primary, secondary, and intermediate. We also have cool colors and warm colors. And space, we're going to look at four different ways of creating space: overlapping, diminishing sizes, vertical placement, and linear perspective.
This entire packet is all or nothing. You cannot leave a page undone.
Turn to page two in your Elements of Art packet. I want you to super focus in the upper left-hand corner of the packet on page two. On the count of three, super focus on the definition for line. Upper left-hand corner. Super focus. One, two, three. Shh. You should be looking down at your paper, and we're going to read that definition together. Line, an element of art that may be two-dimensional, pencil and paper, three-dimensional, wire and rope, or implied, the edge of a shape or a form. Very good. Okay, you can stop reading now. Organic line, a type of line which is free-flowing, curving, and natural. We're going to take your pencil. I'm using a pen so that you can see it, but you need to be using a pencil. And for my class, you need to have a number two wooden pencil, not a mechanical pencil. If you have art pencils you want to bring, cool with me, you don't have to have them. Number two pencil is fine, but you need to make sure that you have a wooden pencil as well as a mechanical pencil, if you want a mechanical pencil. All right, organic line. This is an example of an organic line. Organic line, think about if you're flying in the air and you see a river and how curvy it is. Organic lines are free-flowing and natural. Also, this could be a close-up. You could be looking at a log where insects have chewed a little curvy line through the wood. So in this first space, right here, organic line, I want you to put a circle around organic line so you remember that definition. Also put an oval around the definition for line. These three will be on the test. And the first one, in the first space here, you're going to draw an organic line. Now you're going to draw an organic line and make it fill the entire space. I want you to watch first before you do it. Don't do it yet. And make sure that it doesn't cross over itself. If it crosses over, then it creates a shape. So go ahead and draw. First watch. Sorry, I said draw, but I actually meant for you to watch first. This entire video will replay. Ooh, I got a little too close right there. Look, I created a shape. Whoops, don't do that. This entire video will replay, so if you need to see examples, you're going to have time to go back and catch up. Okay, super focus on the screen again. One, two, three. Shh. Geometric line, a type of line which is man-made, angular, and rigid. This is a geometric line. A geometric line has sharp, sharp corners, no curves. You can't put any curves, no curves. No curves at all on geometric lines. A geometric line could be a maze, could be a zigzag, as long as it's sharp, sharp, sharp angles, no curves. So watch first, and then you draw. You can fill the space. You don't have to make yours exactly like mine, but you need to fill the entire space without touching or overlapping the lines. Go ahead and draw a geometric line. Make sure there are no curves. Don't overlap. They could be zigzag. They could be straight. Any angle, as long as they're sharp angles. Okay. Next one is vertical placement. We have 10 different types of lines that we're going to do down here. Show me with your arm vertical. Hold your arm up vertically. This is how your arm should be when you have your fingers up, when I'm getting everyone's attention. Vertical line, very simple. Straight up and down like a pole, like a flagpole. Horizontal line, show me with your arm, horizontal. Horizontal is left and right. The root word for horizontal is horizon. So if you imagine you're standing on a beach and all you can see is sky and water, and if the water is very calm, that's a horizontal line. It could also be used as a horizon line. So in this space here, you are going to draw a line horizontally. Show me with your arms parallel. Parallel lines never converge. They're going the same direction, but they never, 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 never touch. These are also examples of parallel lines. So parallel lines could be organic and curvy. They could be zigzaggy and geometric. They could be diagonal, be horizontal, they could be vertical, or they could be perpendicular. In this space here, draw example or examples if you like. You can draw more than one of parallel lines. They could be any direction, any way you want to do it, as long as they don't touch. Next one is perpendicular. This is one example of perpendicular. This is another example of perpendicular. The key is that it has to touch. Perpendicular lines converge. Show me with your arms an example of perpendicular. In this space here, draw an example, could be either one of those, of perpendicular. Show me with your arm a diagonal line. Show me diagonal. Corner to corner. Diagonal. Your arms, when your fingers are up and your mouths are closed, should not be diagonal. In this space here, draw a diagonal line. Now the packet has this ridge here, so I would recommend that at this time you pull it over and you fold back the pages so that you can move that crease so it doesn't interrupt the process. So it doesn't interrupt your line. Doesn't create a bump. Kind of make that packet a little bit more user friendly. Fold the pages. Librarians don't really like you to do that to the books, but we need to fold ours. Okay, so fold that so that we can fold that back. Go back to this page, and when we get to curved and other things that are close to the edge, then we can move that. Okay, next one. Zigzag lines. Zigzag lines can look like this. This reminds me of a heart monitor. Beep, 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 beep. I don't know. That probably sounds like you're going to cardiac arrest if I made that noise. It could be diagonal. Doesn't really matter as long as it has sharp, sharp edges. In this space here, draw a zigzag line. Hey. Wavy line. Show me with your arm a wavy line. Okay, a wavy line could be all organic, like this one, or it could be a combination of organic, it's curvy there, and it's geometric at the top. This would be like choppy waves. Or it could come up at a peak. This would be geometric and organic too. Any one of those. I like that one. Go ahead and draw wavy lines. Okay, dashed. Dash lines are like what you see in the middle of the street. The yellow lines, those are dash lines. You can make it any directional line. The line can go any direction. Just make in this space a dash line. So make sure that it's different than the next one, which is dotted line. Dots are dots, dashes are dashes. Make sure that those look different. This is also dotted line. You could do a combination of organic and geometric. This is geometric on this side and then organic on that side. So here do dashed And then do dotted, two different types of line. Now on these two types of line, you have to make sure that it's a path of a moving point. So pretend you're Hansel and Gretel and you've got to find your way here. If it's a bunch of dots and I don't see a path, then it's not a line. And the last one is curves. So the curves could just be partial, part of a circle, or the curve could curve all the way around. Now this doesn't touch anywhere, so it doesn't create a shape. So you can make curved this way, or you can make a spiral. Okay, now when you're finished with this page, then I need for you to go up to the top and write your own definition of line. You can use part of this definition. It doesn't even have to be a full sentence. It's just a way for you to remember, but it has to be completed. So, finish this page and then complete your own definition for line.
Well, I saw the thing coming out of the sky. It had a one long horn and one big eye. I commenced shaking and I said, ooh-wee. It looks like a purple people eater to me. It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
A one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater. Sure looks strange to me.
One-eyed.
Well, he came down to earth and he lit in a tree. I said, Mr. Purple People Eater, don't eat me. I heard him say in a voice so gruff,
I wouldn't eat you, cause you're so tough.
It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater. Sure looks strange to me.
One horn?
I said, Mr. Purple People Eater, what's your line? He said, eating purple people, and it sure is fine. But that's not the reason that I came to land.
Rock and roll band.
Well, bless my soul, rock and roll, flying purple people eater. Pigeon toed undergrowth, flying purple people eater.
We wear short shorts.
Friendly little people eater. What a sight to see.
Oh!
And then he swung from the tree and he lit on the ground and he started to rock, really rocking around. It was a crazy ditty with a swinging tune.
Sing a bop. Boop-a-lap-a-loom-bam-boom.
Well, bless my soul, rock and roll, flying purple people eater. Pigeon-toed, undergrowth, flying purple people eater.
I like short shorts.
Flying purple people eater.
What a sight to see.
Purple people.
Well, he went on his way, and then what do you know? I saw him last night on a TV show. He was blowing it out, really knocking him dead. Playing rock and roll music through the horn in his head.